It's a Marty situation. It's Party Marty. We are live at the 46th Annual CMA Awards Week leading up to the CMA Awards, which are coming up this Thursday night. And someone you know very well, Thunder Nation, absolutely loves the person standing alongside me. In fact, up for a few CMA Awards, too. Miranda Lambert is with us.
Hello.
Hello. Well, how about a shout-out to Thunder Nation?
Hello.
You do that so well. So congratulations on the nominations once again.
Thank you.
Are you excited?
Yes, very.
So when you go out on the awards show, now that you've done this a few times, do you get a little nervous because you have your peers there? Or you just go out there because you seem like the times it's like, I don't care. I'm just going to do it.
I get nervous.
Yeah?
Yeah, I do. Because not only the room makes me nervous with all the other artists there, but then it's also TV, you know?
Yeah.
And I'm notorious for, like, they always make you edit a little bit to cut your song just a little bit shorter or whatever. And I'm notorious for messing those up. So I play, you know, I live. Some people use tracks and things. I always play straight live because my band's like, you never know what she's gonna do. but I love it, you know. It makes you stand on your toes a little bit.
When you do that and you have to edit a song and you're out on stage, do you ever draw a blank and go, wait a second, was I supposed to skip that part?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of times, you know, it's sometimes you just sort of, when you look out there, it you kind of feel like a deer in the headlights, but you don't have time to do that. So you
right.
hold it in and just act like you're all rock and roll.
And how about when you're in the audience and they pan the crowd and you're just smiling and they show the nominations? You,
I know,
you're
sometimes
like, okay, cameras on me, smile.
Yeah, sometimes you forget, you know, and like my friends will text me and be like, are you pissed? You look pissed. I'm like, no, I was just like watching, you know, wasn't paying attention, just, you know.
Very good. And, of course, Miranda Lambert's coming to New Jersey in January with your good friend Dierks Bentley.
Yes.
Tell us about the tour.
It's going to be awesome. We've toured together twice already, and
right.
it was awesome both times, and it was called Locked and Loaded. So we're calling this tour Locked and Reloaded. Dierks and I have great chemistry. We're great friends, and we have kind of the same rock and roll attitude and fans, and it's going to be awesome. We are both the kind of people that will learn from each other too, you know, like watch each other every night and try to one up each other
right.
in a good way. And so I think it'll just be like the longer the tour goes on, the better, you know. So but I know that at the beginning we're gonna be so fired up because we haven't gotten a tour together in a while, and it's gonna be awesome.
Speaking of one upping each other, when it comes to Blake Shelton, your husband, and the CMA Awards are on and he's up for an award and you're up for an award and he wins it, do you feel like, I want to win this award? Because when we get home, I want to tell him, I beat you on this one.
We used to be like that a lot. Now it's like, it's kind of, we're both really doing well in our own rights. You know, I've got the Pistol Annies and my tours and stuff going great. And he's got The Voice, which is like the biggest TV show on the planet
yeah,
right now. So,
that show, The Voice.
Yeah. And so, you know, we're not really like that anymore. But this year at the CMAs, we have a song nominated together for Song of the Year that we wrote together. So that's really cool. It's kind of bonding, and he won't talk about it because he thinks you can jinx stuff. And I'm like, no, I want to win it so bad. He's like, don't talk about it. You're going to jinx it. But, you know, he's definitely, I'm a little bit more competitive on award fronts than he is. I'm like, no, I want to freaking take it home. And he's like, it's okay if we don't win. I'm like, no, it's not.
Speaking of feeling like you're jinxing, do you feel like, well, maybe I shouldn't prepare my speech before I go out? Or do you have something ready to go just in case you win?
I usually just, you know, I feel like if I never win another award, I feel blessed to have already won what I have. And I do believe there's a time that comes that you should pass the torch, you know, and I'm fine with that, but I never have one Song of the Year that I wrote, so I do feel like it would be important to me to win that. But I usually just, if I do win, I go with my heart. Whatever comes to my mind, I say, and sometimes it's dumb, and sometimes it's heartfelt, and sometimes it's smart, but I don't know. I just go with it.
All right. There you go. Well, I wish you best of luck at the CMA Awards.
Thank you very much.
And Thunder Nation, of course, rooting for you as well and for Blake. And we can't wait to see you and Dierks Bentley coming to town in January.
Thank you.
All right. Miranda Lambert's with us live, CMA Week here in Nashville. One more time for Thunder Nation.
Hi, y'all. See you later.